Alright, hello guys, in this video we're going to be talking about my official September forecast as we're starting to close out the month of August and Dorian is on the way. There will be more updates for Dorian coming up soon, but we're going to talk about my September forecast in this video. We're going to be starting out with the precipitation forecast, then temperature forecast, and then overall forecast. But before I get started with this video though, I would ask that you do subscribe if you do like weather-related content, and also make sure to check out our links in the description for our social medias. Now let's get right into things. We're looking at our precipitation forecast first off. Now, you can see there is a lot going on here, and I'm going to break it down for you guys and try to help you understand what you're looking at here. I want to start out here on the northwest coast of the United States. You can see Northern California in through coastal Oregon and coastal Washington is in that brown shade. You can see that is below average if you look at the top bar there. That is our first shade of below average precipitation, meaning it's going to be pretty below average precipitation, but it might not be too noticeable. Now, as you start to get into those moderate shades and the darker shades, that's when you start to notice it more and more. You can see that we do have our green areas here for the central United States into the kind of north central, northeastern United States area. Now, in the lighter shade of green, it's kind of the same story as the lighter shade of brown, where we're going to be dealing with slightly above average precipitation, and it might not be too noticeable throughout these areas. Obviously, this is a very large area, so there will be areas where it's not really above average, but most areas within this color shade will be above average, and it will vary how much above average it is, obviously, from Michigan into Nevada. Somewhere in there is going to be some differences. We do have our darker shade of green here within that lighter shade. This area extends from Montana down through Idaho into some of those southern Rockies there down into New Mexico. You can see we are going to be dealing with further above average precipitation within this area. This area is in our moderate shade of green, and it will be further noticeable. It will be quite stormy throughout September within this region here, this southern Rockies region. And again, I want to note here that as we move into September, specifically later September, that's when we're going to be starting to talk about snowfall for especially the northern Rockies. And I have seen it in the southern Rockies before, but usually September is more extreme, you know, high elevation areas in the northern Rockies. And then October and November, we start talking about the southern Rockies more and more lower elevation areas. But nothing is impossible, so we could be dealing with some snow, especially towards the later portion of September. That's just something you want to note there for those Rockies region of the United States. We do have a second region of below average precipitation here for the eastern United States. This extends from about Dallas and Oklahoma City eastward into some of those northern Gulf states, some of the southern Appalachians, and into the East Coast. Then that extends into the New England regions of the United States and the northeastern regions of the United States. In that lightest shade of tan, we're obviously dealing again with the slightly below average precipitation, and you might not notice it too much, but I have drawn out an area here in the medium shade of brown from Tennessee, northern Alabama, northern Mississippi, northern Georgia, up through the mid-Atlantic states into the coastal regions of the Northeast and New England. These areas are going to be particularly below average as far as precipitation is concerned, and I think that it will be for the most part quite dry throughout the month of September. And if I remember correctly, last September we were dealing with a lot of rain actually for Pennsylvania, Maryland, West Virginia, areas like that. We're dealing with extremely above average precipitation, so this is almost the opposite here that we're dealing with. There will be rain at times, and obviously some areas might see some rain throughout this month, but for the most part, these areas will be quite dry. Also, if any sort of hurricane hits any of these areas in the below average precipitation region, you can kind of go ahead and scratch that forecast off, because that would switch things up a lot. You can see down here in Florida, we do have a second area of above average precipitation, and this is mostly for Dorian. There's not much else that is leading me to believe there will be much above average precipitation for this area, but we do have Dorian on the way, which is going to automatically put you guys in that above average column just with how much rainfall we're expecting with that storm. That's going to be arriving on the 1st, 2nd, and 3rd of September. Now, we're going to go ahead and move on to our temperature forecast here, and you can see there isn't much extremes going on. I'm not expecting anywhere to be too far above or below average as far as temperatures are concerned, but you can see for the West Coast, extending almost all the way to the Rockies, we do have an above average area of temperatures. This extends from, again, the West Coast and then pretty close into the Rockies. It extends past the Northern Rockies and doesn't quite reach the Southern Rockies as it kind of stalls out in those four corner states there, but these areas will be dealing with slightly above average temperatures. Again, in some regions, you won't really notice this too much, and I think it's going to be quite a flip-floppy month here. There will be times when the West Coast is cold, and there will be times when it's warm. I'm just thinking there's going to be more times when it's warmer than average than there is going to be times when it's colder than average. Same story for the southeastern United States here. You can see from Alabama, Georgia, South Carolina, North Carolina, and Florida. We're expecting slightly above average temperatures for this region as well. I think there's going to be a little bit of a ridge setting up there, and this will lead to some slightly above average temperatures for this region. And if you watched my fall forecast, I was also calling for this region to be in the above average column. So this is just going to set things off in the right note, as we're going to be dealing with some slightly above average temperatures for this region. Now, for the central northern United States, we're going to be dealing with some below average temperatures from the Dakotas southward into Kansas, Oklahoma, areas like that, just eastward of those Rockies and southern Rockies. We're going to be dealing with some slightly below average temperatures, and that extends northward, northeastward, into the Great Lakes regions of the United States and kind of touches some of those interior northeastern regions of the United States as well. I think later in the month, we could see that cold start to try to move east and try to get New England into some of that below average. So if we took the average from the 15th of September all the way to the end of the month, I think we will be dealing with some below average temperatures for the northeastern United States. But for that first half, I think it's going to be quite average. So that's why we're going to go ahead and call for average temperatures for you guys along the coast and in the New England states of the United States. But for the Great Lakes, North Central, and then kind of those Great Plains regions of the United States, we're going to be dealing with some below average temperatures for the most part. Now we're going to go ahead and move on to our overall forecast for the month of September here. You can see we're going to start out things on the northwest coast of the United States, and we're going to be dealing with some pretty dry conditions here. Again, you saw my precipitation forecast. We will be seeing some below average precipitation for this region, and it all just makes sense why we would see pretty dry conditions for this region. Now for most of the western United States, the west coast into the areas just to the west of the Rockies, we're going to be dealing with warmer than normal conditions. You saw that on my temperature forecast. This is quite obvious why I'm saying this, because I'm calling that for that on my temperature forecast. It will be warmer than normal within most of these regions in this orange shade here in the western United States. For this green region here, for some of those southern Rockies and central Rockies, we're going to be dealing with some pretty stormy conditions. Again, wouldn't be surprised if we do see some snow in the month of September, especially there for the northern Rockies, but it's not unheard of to see some in the southern Rockies as well later in the month of September. So we're going to be dealing with some pretty stormy conditions. For the most part, just rain, possibly some snow within that region, and some possibly for that orange region there in the northern Rockies for Montana and Idaho. Now, just to your southeast, we do have some relief from the ridge we've been dealing with throughout the month of August for Texas, New Mexico, into Oklahoma, Arkansas, Louisiana. All of these areas are going to cool off quite a little bit. This doesn't necessarily mean we're going to see below average temperatures for this region, but it won't be quite as warm as it has been in August. It was far above average temperatures in Texas and Oklahoma for most of the month of August, and that's just not going to be the case for September. We're going to see a lot of relief from this ridge, and it's going to be a very different story in September. So hopefully that's a lot of good news for you guys down there in the South Central United States. Now to your north, we are going to be dealing with colder than normal conditions. Obviously, there will be some cold outbreaks here from Canada. That's basically what we're calling for here for those northern plains into some of those Great Lakes regions. We're going to be seeing some of those colder temperatures come from Canada into the central United States. Obviously, it will be warm at times, but there will be so many of those cold outbreaks that I think it is going to come out on paper as below average temperatures for this region. And again, as we look eastward, cold at times, especially late there for the northeastern United States. Especially late means especially later in the month. That's what I mean by especially late. So after the 15th, particularly, I think we could be dealing with some colder temperatures there for the northeastern United States, as well as some of those Great Lakes regions and Kentucky, Ohio, Indiana, areas like that could be dealing with colder than average temperatures later in the month. Now, for your Gulf states and some of those southeast coast regions, we're going to be dealing with tropical activity, obviously with Dorian for Florida here. And then, you know, it's kind of a question mark after that. Will we be dealing with more tropical storms for the coasts? It is always possible, and I can't really forecast for that not to happen. It's always, always possible. To your north, we're going to be dealing with warmer than normal temperatures from Mississippi through Alabama, Georgia, South Carolina, North Carolina, Virginia. These areas will be dealing with some warmer than normal conditions throughout the month of September. And then to your north, it's going to be pretty dry there for some of those interior mid-Atlantic, interior northeastern regions of the United States, as well as coastal northeastern United States, just to the south of New England. We'll be dealing with some pretty dry conditions for the month of September. Anyway, guys, I hope you really, really enjoyed this September forecast. As always, if you subscribe to my channel, I'll be bringing these monthly forecasts. I think the last month that I missed was actually December of 2018. So it's been a long time since I've missed a monthly forecast. We've had these out consistently since then. And before then, I think we were on like a 5-month streak before that. So we do these very consistently, as well as seasonal forecasts that are very similar to this, except they're a forecast for 3-month periods. So you can check out our winter forecasts and fall forecasts that we've come out with in the past. Anyway, guys, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.